so many different ways of grooming, so many, you know, everybody has their own way. I just want everybody to see the way that I'm doing it and to see if they like it.
It can get so hot when it's 103 degrees. Should have lived and make you mean. Please don't stay so close to me. Frank has got a dream that's going to get him paid.
A lot of mobile groomers are out there right now alone.
Right.
They don't have any inspiration. They don't have anybody to encourage them.
As I've been a groomer for 25 years, it's been pretty stressful. I've hurt my body. I've been stressed out. I think different things. And now, as being a groomer, I find it to be very calming to be able to go to work and know that the different techniques that I've discovered over the years is calming for me and calming for the pets. And I have discovered a new way. Calming the dog or cat down without pulling mats, without jerking them around, without demanding them to sit or demanding them to stand. I don't know, we just kind of go into each other in an easy way. If I could show you with my hands and with my body language and while I'm touching my dogs, because everything I do with the dogs is in my body language, is in my heartbeat, is in just a whisper.
Yeah, it seems to me like you're talking about a form of communication that you use through your hands. Work with them and not against them.
Yes, and even if they're the type of dog that won't sit still, I don't know what it is. I kind of go around them as they're twirling. My scissors kind of twirl with them. I call it the little blender. And even if they're a little wiggly dog, they might wiggle, and then I'll catch a little cut on the down low, or I'll catch a little cut on the up low. I don't really want to stress out.
It's so different. This type of connection that I see that you have with these animals.
What I'm going to ask, I think, first of all, is if everybody could overlook the technical parts of everything. Can't ask the animals to retake because it's done on the spur. And what I'm doing out here is on the moment. And there's so many ways to do things out here. Or maybe new groomers that are up and coming, who are already, no pun intended, because it's getting a handle on things.
Like I said, I try to go with them.
People don't realize that these dogs can't understand what we're saying, but they can feel what we're saying.
In the video, you may watch how I groom as I go. How sometimes I'm talking to people and I just continue on. I just allow the dog to go, move around while people are there, just continually moving while the dog is going, and the dog sometimes doesn't even know what happened and it's done.
Yeah.
You'll see that in the video. And yes, I might be lifting the dog, I might be moving the dog's foot, bringing the dog around, and I really want everybody to watch that, to see those different things, to pay attention to the little slightest maneuvers.
Those shapes at any
interesting
level.
Interesting. Do you want to see your face? What do you look like?
One thing I've noticed with the dogs that you're working with, they know you. They can't wait to jump in the van. That has to say something about the relationship that you're building with them. They appreciate this. They have the ability to appreciate this handling and trust you and know that you care about how they feel. I mean, I know with working with horses, they say they don't care how much you know till they know how much you care.
Certain dogs that have been difficult, but we've developed like a relationship, they know that I'm not going to hurt them. They wait for the moment, like maybe it's their nails, maybe it is the pads of their feet. Maybe it is their face that they don't like. Just certain areas that I already know that was hard for them before. But in that one area that I know, we look at each other. They look at me. I look at them. It's like we nod to each other and give each other that moment. And they trust me in that moment to know that I am going to do what they expect.
If a dog wants to lie down on the table, she's going to just turn. There she goes. She wants to sit. And that's just perfectly fine with me. So I'm going to let her sit. I'm not going to force her to stand. If she wants to sit and lay down, I'm just going to let her do that.
Doing something to a dog, you're doing something with a dog.
And for the dog.
And for the dog.
Yes, with and for. I don't want him screaming. I don't want him biting me.
Scrubbing floors on your hands and knees. City living can get so hot when it's 103 degrees. City living will make you mean. Please don't stand so close to me. Frankie's got a dream, it's gonna get him paid. Jenny said don't forget me.
That's what my Robin Lee... No. And that's what Robin Lee Instructional Videos wants to be all about.
Woohoo!
Absolutely.
All right.